Hey guys, welcome to SubriZone. We are learning Laravel from scratch and this is lecture number 8. As you know, now we have full CRUD application. So now all we have to do is to use the authentication system. In order to use authentication system, you will go to your terminal and we will type here PHP artisan make auth and hit enter. Oh, the Laravel authentication system have the same layout as I have. In the layout folder, they also have app.blade.php. If I could show you, we have the same thing. So it is asking me to replace it. I want to just cut this code so that we have this code. I'm going to copy it and creating a new file and I'm going to paste it. Now, if we will go back to browser and if I refresh this page, you can see we have now register and login nav. Now, if we will go back to our old nav bar, what type of things or which things we need, we will copy here. So I need this UL and I am going to copy it. And if we will come to our new nav bar, right before if condition, we will paste this nav bar. Okay, now we have our old nav bar in the new one. And if we will go to our app.blade.php, here we have to write some content and that content is saved here. So I will gonna copy this section and I am going to paste it inside this section and let's save it. Another thing which we need is the script code which we were added for CK editor. So I am going to copy this code too and we are going to paste right before the ending body tag. Let's save it and go to browser and refresh page once again. Okay, now as you can see, now we have two nav bars, but here you can see we have our home, about, services and blog page and create post page too. Okay. As you can see, my code is printing two times and I will fix it in just a minute. But before we do that, we need to change our nav bar. We will gonna remove one of this nav bar. So we will keep new one with us and I am going to remove the old one. Okay, let's save it and go to browser and refresh it once again. Okay, as you can see, we have the yield content two times, so I am removing first one. And now if I will refresh this page, we will have the single one. That's great. Okay, now if we will try to make someone authenticate, so if I will click on login, we have a login form here, but because no one, there is not any user in our database. If I could show you, here we have the users table and inside this user table we have not any user till now. So we have to create a user first. So here if I will click on register, I will get a registration form where first of all I need to write the name. So on this dashboard I need to create a link to create post. So I didn't want that link outside of this nav bar just because only that person authenticate person can create post who have logged in. So I am going to remove this and we will go back to our home.blade.php, and inside this first of all I will write here h3 and I will write here your blog post, and before this blog post I am going to paste that link. Remove this ally and give the href a class of btn default. And now if I will save it and go to browser and refresh it, we have a create post link. Now our navbar is looking good and we have a create post link inside our authentication system. So if any user will click on create post, he will go to this section. We will make sure only authenticate user can create a post, but we need to save the username and user ID too. In order to do that, we will create a user ID column. To make a user ID column, we will go to CMD and here we will gonna type PHP artisan make migration, and now the detail of that migration, which is add user ID, which is our column name, to post. This post is our table name. Here it is. So now if I will run this query, as you can see here the user ID is created successfully. So I need to write some code, schema dots table. It will get two parameters. First of all is the table name and the function. Inside this function we have a parameter of variable table, and now we will gonna add a field here which is table, and data type which is integer, and now the table column name which is user ID. And a termination. Similarly, we will do the same thing with the down function. So I am going to copy this and I am going to paste it right here. But this time we will not gonna ask for integer, we will gonna ask for drop column. And now we will go to our CMD and write here PHP artisan migrate and hit enter. So we have a error on line 19. So let's check it out. Line 19, we have here this termination point. Let's save it and go to browser and rerun this command. Okay, now successfully done. If I will minimize and go to our XAMPP and refresh this, as you can see we have a user ID field here. So we will manually change it to 1, because you know we have only one user with the user ID of 1. So I am going to make it 1. We want to save this user ID automatically. In order to do that, the user must have been logged in, and if a user have logged in, he will definitely have a user ID, and that user ID will automatically gonna save. In order to do that, we will go to our post controller, and here in the store function all we have to do is just pass the user ID. So I will write here $post user ID is equal to auth user, and you can get now any one of fields of that user, and I need only ID. Okay, now save this, and if we will go to our browser, and now if we will try to submit a form once again, create post. So I will heading for, this is heading for, and we are testing user ID. Okay, now if I will submit this form, heading 4 is here, and if I could show you, it have the same data which we have inserted. So if we will go to database and refresh this page once again, you can see we have a user ID which is automatically saved inside this database. So if we will go to our project, as you can see in the navbar, we have not any link so that user can go to its dashboard or that page where the user came after logging in. So we will add that link to in our navbar. So we will go to our navbar, and I am going to copy this li, and I am going to paste it inside this drop down so that the user have the home link inside the drop down anytime and anywhere, and I am going to name it as blog home. Save it and go to browser and refresh it once again, and this time if I will click to Mohsin, we have our home blog home link here, and if I will click on this, we have our dashboard here. I hope this lecture will help you a lot. For more, please subscribe and leave a like, because I work hard to make videos for you. Thanks for watching.